According to Torah, if a woman sleep with another man, you should what? Stone her to death. So that's the Torah, okay? Did Jesus come to follow that law?
Why did Allah say Satan? Why did Allah say Satan? Don't use me as a diversion. He just wants to
call out the lie.
Call out the lie. Liar. Antichrist.
You know when I come here, I expose people. Christian prayers don't come here, you get exposed.
You're running from the show. You're running from the show.
Yeah.
Is that okay?
If God says.
If God says it's okay to kill somebody. It's
well,
okay
we have to
kill
we have to establish that God was speaking to this person.
Yeah. How would you get
No, you can't just you record. No. Have someone else record from the brothers.
I'm recording.
Yeah, no. Even from the brothers, they want to go.
No, just
where is the channel?
Filming.
He has no channel over there.
They're all busy, look.
No, wait, because I can't just one record. I don't. He told me he edits.
Okay, we'll do it later.
No, record. From the brothers, isn't it? Like, the one who knows which one.
Oh, we're not brothers.
You are a brother, sister. Okay, your sister, no brother.
Yeah.
That's my record,
yeah.
Yeah, I want to ask.
So I got confronted, boy.
I'm not going to get into a long thing. I just want to.
Yeah, let's use the hands up.
I'm going with you.
Okay, yeah, no problem.
Just establish.
That's a good point. That's a good point.
Is it okay to kill if God says it's okay to kill? That's all I want to understand. Forget whether we can prove that person was told to be killed by God.
Yeah.
Is it sanctioned?
Is what? I'll say that again.
Is it sanctioned to? Can you kill if God says it's okay to kill?
Well, if God gives you an order, then you would have to.
So you can?
Well, yeah.
So if somebody kills in the name of God?
No, not if someone kills in the name of God. Because anyone can. There's a distinction. Right. If you believe you're doing it, many people have done stuff in the name of God, but God has not spoken to them.
Shamsi said that they had deemed the CPU.
Well, that's what we have. That's
talking
what we have
about
to
women being then taken understand out because. Women. That is not
for example, let's say
hadith.
Moses.
He's alive.
Now, we won't believe in Moses. So we'll say Moses received. Whether you believe Moses killed people or not.
He's calling me a clown again.
He's
rattled. Because his hands were shaking like a guy on MS.
But if someone,
we're not going to let him get away with it today. We're going to expose the liar.
Did you say his point? His point, you're going to claim.
No, but he said if they believe.
No, his point that you believe.
Because I can say ISIS believe.
That's what I'm saying.
Allah is giving them instructions.
No,
where you might say, well, they're not proper Muslims.
I just want to establish your principle. That's okay. All.
The so, point.
Because I know, for example, and I'm going to say, I'm not here for long, but anyway. I know, for example, the second commandment, thou shalt not kill.
Yes.
Okay. And then straight after it, Moses orders the killing of 3,000 people.
Okay.
So we know thou shalt not kill has got nothing to do with the actual taking of somebody's life. It's about the sanctioning of taking life. Yeah. So you believe, as a Christian, it's God command when God commands you somebody to kill, you're happy with that. It's fine. Not a problem. That's what I want to understand.
Well, no, yeah, no,
babies, good babies.
Yeah, babies and everything. Men, women, children. It doesn't really matter.
Well, in the Quran, No, because he's saying babies.
Don't use the shaitan.
You're mentioning babies.
Use shaitan.
We were just talking about killing. Why are you mentioning babies?
Is the Quran shaitan's book or God's book?
It's Shaitan's book.
So why use Shaitan to support your
because
God?
You believe it's God.
No. He's talking about you. It's not about me.
Yeah, but you
So they're using Shaitan to support their claim.
No, because you're talking about children.
So Shaitan,
I was talking to him.
You tried to justify Shaitan's
action.
And
you interjected about
children.
You just
got finished now.
No.
I'm just trying to understand the principle.
Okay, so he talked about Shaitan.
I just
would love you to give me a chance, brother.
I just want
to ask you.
No, I just want to ask you. I will.
Can I just defend you on one of these? I've got this hadith,
okay.
And he's gonna. Let me just say this hadith because he said about Shaitan. So I won't talk to him because he's a coward and he doesn't like to hear the truth. But I'm gonna say Sahih al-Bukhari 1125. Gabriel did not come to the Prophet for some time. So one of the Quraysh women said, his Satan has deserted him. So came the divine revelation by the forenoon and by the night, when it is still, your Lord Muhammad has neither forsaken you nor hated you. Now, Muslims say that. This is not in the Quran. So guess what? At the bottom of this hadith, references the Quran. So now we're going to prove that Allah is Satan, like I've been telling you. Okay. And it's Quran 93, verse 1 to 3. Yeah, now you see, this is why they get upset. But let me finish. No, let me read the Quranic verse.
It's lying.
This is the Quranic verse. 93. No.
Allah said,
let me read the Quranic verse. We're not going to hear. Shamsi doesn't know his own. The Quranic verse. So this is it. By the forenoon and by the night. When darkness.
Shamsi. Wait. Because this is what I want to ask you, Shamsi. Because. We've spoken many times.
And you don't listen.
Wait. Because we were talking about can God allow someone to be killed? So I said we have to establish that this person spoke to God. So now let me ask you.
No, wait.
Because you're saying he's saying Christians say Muhammad did X, Y, and Z.
He's shouting.
So then we have to then establish. Okay, because they're doing it from a point of view that Muhammad was in. Inspired by Satan. So if he was inspired by the Allah, who's the true God, then yes, then you can't argue about it.
What are you talking about?
Because you said you were talking about killing. Yes.
No.
Said Christian.
Bro, don't talk about behalf, and you start talking.
You said,
it's not fair. You start talking directly. We are not the other side, not hearing what I'm saying.
So say what you're saying.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Okay.
My point was to you. Yes. The Christian missionaries always, the church say, Prophet Muhammad cannot be a prophet because he kills enemies.
Okay.
Prophet Muhammad cannot be a prophet because he had many wives. Prophet Muhammad cannot be a prophet because of this and that. Okay. I'm saying the Christians, they have double standard. Because you believe Jesus as a mighty God who is better and perfect than Jesus was a human being. Correct?
Make your point.
No, is it correct or not?
Make your point.
No, before I make my point.
No, make your point.
No, I'm not going to make respond. It. No, I'm not going to give 20 minutes, 20 hours.
I didn't say 20 hours. I said make your point and
is it correct what I'm saying?
Make your point and
I'll
respond.
Is it correct?
Yeah, make your point.
You can speak for yourself.
Yeah, make your point and I'll respond.
Is it correct?
Just make your point and I'll respond.
I'm not going to carry on until it's correct.
If it's correct, I'll respond.
No, I want to see if you are sincere speaking or you're just going to speak for the sake of camera.
I'm not speaking. I'm saying make your point and I'll respond to it.
I'm asking you. Is it?
Just make your point.
That is my point. My point. Jesus as God. He was here more merciful and more perfect than Jesus as human. That's my question.
They were the same. Jesus was. You're okay. Making a fallacy in saying Jesus as God and Jesus as man. Yeah. They're the same person.
Same. So when Jesus said he has another hour, was he same?
Now we're jumping.
You just lied.
We're jumping.
No, they were same.
No, we're jumping.
Expose you lying.
No, because we're talking
were they same
about.
Or different?
See, this is why I say to you, make your statement and I respond because you're jumping.
Yeah, I'm saying.
No. Everyone can see.
No.
I said to you, make your statement so I can respond. As soon as I ask this question, you jump to something else. This is why I have to let you do.
You lie. You lie.
No. You asked me a question. You asked me a question. Now it's my turn to ask you a question.
No. I haven't asked a question. When you said Jesus and God, Jesus.
Answer the question.
I said they're the same.
No, I said this.
I answered your question.
Wait.
You see, everyone's watching
bro,
noticing he does not allow people to speak.
No.
Let me ask me a question.
No, you're lying. You're lying.
You said, are they lying. You said, are they.
Look at your subject.
You said, are they the same? I said, they're the same.
So I'm going to prove you're lying.
Now I'm going to
ask you.
No,
you're lying.
I'm asking you.
You're lying.
How am I lying?
I'll tell you, that's a good question. I'm lying.
Okay.
He said, Jesus as God and a man as the same. But Jesus, according to the Bible, said the Father is greater than
I. Is this a new topic?
No. You said Jesus and God are the same.
I
just spoke to you
guys. Now I'm going to make my statement.
Anyone say Jesus?
No, we're not jumping.
Now listen.
We're sticking to the main point.
I
know, I'm like a volcano.
Shamsi, I have a question. You are an agent of Satan.
What's the context of what you quoted?
You are an agent of Satan.
What's the context?
Please
let me speak.
Okay. Okay.
What is the context of Jesus saying that the Father is greater than I?
I'm going to talk about, because I said...
No.
No.
You're right. You said Jesus has not saved. I just broke your life.
Abbas even said the Quran has contradictions. I recorded the video. Abbas said the Quran has contradictions. And we're going to show that Allah is a liar. We are going
to expose him. I haven't had a chance to speak. He's been speaking for 10 minutes. You see? This is how it works. Okay. You keep saying you're going to go. I said, I haven't been able to speak.
You said Jesus.
We're jumping. Let me make my statement.
You made a statement.
Let me make my statement.
You're wrong.
You see, he doesn't want to address.
No, I'm dealing with the points.
He's open. He said that I was going on topic because we were talking about people being killed if God tells someone to do something. I said.
He's speaking to me. Tell him to stop.
I said.
Can you tell him to stop?
I said, brother, come on.
I said, we have to.
Bring it down to the point.
I've been here 10 minutes.
What is the point?
Because
what's the point?
We were talking about
here, bro.
You interrupted him.
We were talking about God giving orders to a prophet.
Yes.
So I said we have to establish his person was a prophet.
I didn't say that.
That's what I said.
No.
If we're going to judge the person's action, we have to establish is this person.
I'll get you the
prophet. When I came to you, that's how I came to you. I said to you, paper boy. The Christian missionaries, always on the camera, they're talking about Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the mighty messenger.
He's a false prophet.
And can you tell me to be quiet?
If you are clear.
Yeah, go on.
Okay. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he cannot be a prophet because he killed his enemies. He cannot be a prophet because... Let me finish my point.
Let him make his point and expose himself. Let him make his point.
Christian...
Go on, sir. Go on.
Come on. Okay. He's recording.
Go on, please.
So he cannot be a prophet because what? He done this and that.
So
I'm saying, I'm saying, Christian, be consistent. You have your Jesus. Your God, Jesus. Then I ask the question. Jesus, who is more merciful and more loving, and more caring.
Jesus.
Jesus as God.
Jesus, full stop.
Have you finished?
I'm finished.
Bye-bye.
Hold on, wait.
Wait, notice that he first said about the killing. Then he's saying about Jesus. They're two different topics.
No, it's not.
Yes, they are. Because if we're talking about the actions of a prophet, we have to then establish the prophet was a true prophet.
I'm coming to
whether Jesus was whether Jesus was more was this or that is irrelevant. We have to establish whether this first, the prophet's actions were just
I want to say carefully. I'm saying that's what my point. My point that your people say Prophet Muhammad did evil actions. What is his evil actions? He kills enemies. No, he was not a prophet.
Okay.
You never said that. You only believe he was not a prophet. When you speak to Muslims and you try to misguide the Muslims,
what
you
kind tell of prophet them, a 6-year-old girl and desires that girl? You tell me what kind of
Isaac,
prophet
Isaac,
of God?
Isaac,
what kind of prophet of God?
Wait,
6-year-old girl and desires that girl? Answer! What kind of prophet?
Isaac, the point of this debate.
No,
let me speak. I'm not looking up because I'm scared, because it's called a useless debate.
Run away, because you've got no answer.
They're shouting. I'm not letting you watch. Come with me, Pepper Boy. Pepper Boy, you know how to deal with them. Don't be scared. We don't have about you. Come.
Let me just establish. This is Speaker's Corner. What's happening with you?
Pepper Boy, come here. Point. You missing the point. The point is that you people say Prophet Muhammad did evil actions. Where is evil actions? He kills enemies. He fights. Jesus never fight, never killed. So my question to you people, now you are, if you are saying God, Prophet Muhammad was evil because he fought against enemies, you shaking, man.
It's cold.
Okay. He kills enemies and so on. Then I want to know, when Jesus was God, was he still merciful and caring and loving? Because when Jesus was God, he was telling people to kill babies and children and to burn their daughters alive.
Now, the reason why you're making a kind of straw man point, because I've not said that. I've not said that personally, so I cannot. I cannot argue.
What's going on, man?
What I've not heard. I cannot argue for what I've not heard someone else see. So that's why I said, first of all, if he might have misunderstood what people have said. So I said, we have to first establish this person was a prophet, right? Because then if some God gives you a revelation to do something, then ultimately, as believers of God, we say you have to obey what God says.
Okay, establish Moses as a prophet.
So now,
No. Establish Moses as a prophet when you kill the babies.
Wait. So now,
watch this one. Establish Moses as a prophet.
I'm going to ask you a question because you keep asking me questions.
Keep asking questions, mate.
Since you've been at this park, right?
Yeah.
You've spoken to many Jews and many Christians.
And I finished all of them. Only one of them.
And you've asked them, like, what is a prophet for a criteria? So in your own,
and you differed.
In your opinion,
yeah.
Have you ever come across a criteria for to establish who is a prophet?
According with the Jews and the Christians, when I speak to them,
yeah,
they differ. Like when you look to one of the Christian the Jews rabbis, his what's name? Ibn Maimun. Maimonide.
Okay.
Maimonide, one of the
Maimonides.
Maimonides, his followers. Maybe.
Yeah.
By his name, yeah, but he's well respected, and his criteria for a prophet. Do you know where is it?
What?
Completely go and guess what you said.
Okay.
You see what I'm saying? That's why as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, mukhtalifun.
He's
a criteria. He has to come to fulfill the Torah. Would Jesus not do that? Okay? Jesus went against it here, clearly. Because in the Torah, you don't have to kill yourself to forgive your sins. Okay?
And what about Christians?
You have to kill yourself. Show me when the Moses killed himself.
You're getting distracted. And what about Christians?
Okay, so the Christians believe, according to the Torah, if you do righteous actions and you repent to God, then you're okay. According to the Torah, if someone changes religion, you should kill him to death. According to the Torah, if a woman sleeps with another man, you should what? Stone her to death. So that's the Torah, okay? Did Jesus come to follow that law?
Okay, so now I've got a question because...
Look, he's not answering.
Answer my question.
That's my question.
Answer. Okay, this is your question and I'll give you a question.
Maimun, one of those... in Arabic, it's Maimun, the son of Maimun, yeah?
Okay.
I forgot his name. Anyone knows his name in English. Him, he said the criteria for a prophet.
Yeah.
He said, that's one of them. He has to fulfill the Torah. He has to come with the Torah. Bring in the Torah, not go against it.
Okay.
Bring in the Torah, the law. Yeah?
Okay.
The other criteria he said, if he prophesies about something good and doesn't occur in the future, he's still a prophet. But if it's something bad and it doesn't occur, he's not a prophet. So what?
Just say it again.
I know it's confusing. Even me, I got confused. He said, yep. If a prophet prophesies about something is good in the future,
okay.
I mean, the other way around. We have to check it out, yeah? I know it's still here. You know, remember. If a prophet prophesies about something in the future, good or bad, one of them, I can't remember, does it not happen, he prophesies it. He said it will come, it will happen. Yeah. But does it not happen, that does not invalidate his prophethood. But if he prophesies about something else, I can't remember which one, and it doesn't happen, he's not a prophet. Can you explain that? That doesn't make any sense. To be honest.
Well, I can't explain it because I'm not sure what this source is. I've never come across this.
Okay, Ibn Maymun mentioned that in his articles. But anyway, so my main point here,
okay.
Jesus, because one of the criteria of the Jews to know true prophets, he has to come with the law of the Torah. Did Jesus come with the Torah, the law of Torah?
That's his fourth question, by the way. That's his fourth question,
by the way. No, I haven't answered it. Yeah. Did Jesus come with the Torah? That's what the one, first one.
Jesus came with the Torah?
So did Jesus come with stoning the woman to death?
Say that again?
I speak in English. Did Jesus come to stone a woman to death? The adulterer.
So
you made mistakes to come to me.
No.
You call Christian Prince.
So when Jesus Stop came, coming. He told the people to follow the Torah. That's the answer to the question.
No. The Jewish rabbis, they say, yes. In order for someone to be a prophet, okay. He has to come with the Torah.
Okay.
Not tell the people. He has himself, he has to follow the Torah and call people to follow the law of the Torah. So my question to you, listen carefully. When Jesus came, did he come with stoning a woman to death and killing the apostate?
Let's stick with the Torah because you're asking two
questions. There's
a Torah. He instructed people to obey the Torah.
Which is stoning a woman to death.
He told people to obey the laws of the Torah.
I'm asking you a simple question.
All the laws of the Torah, which is the 613 laws that Jews follow.
But how come in the Bible says the woman said don't stone her?
He said, I've come to fulfill the law. But he told people to follow the Torah, right?
So don't tell me Jesus said that. Yes. Let us analyze if it did happen or not. Did Jesus stone a woman to death when a woman came to him, the fornicator?
He didn't stone anyone.
No, what did he say about the adulterous woman?
Tell us, because you're asking me a question.
Okay, there's a story.
I'm going to ask you a question.
Before you ask, no.
Yeah, because you've asked me a question. I've answered your question.
Paper boy, I can't see you clearly.
No.
You're striking now.
No.
I don't know what to do.
Make your statement.
Paper boy, look, listen what I'm saying. You said to me, Shamsi, the problem with you misunderstanding what the Christian missionaries are saying. Yes. They're not saying because he killed.
That's why I asked you to explain yourself.
Let me finish my point. Let me finish. You saying it's not about killing, it's about establishing someone a true prophet. I said, okay, I ask you, prove to me that Moses is a true prophet. Then you ignored it. I said, prove to me. Then I said to you, no. You know the Jews, they differ with you. The Jews, they say, in order for someone to be a true prophet, he has to come with the Torah, with the law of the Torah. I ask you the question, did Jesus come with the Torah, the law? Establishing the law, okay? Uh-huh. And I'm asking you again, when a woman, according to the Bible, when always a Christian tried to use these passages to the Muslim, show them the love of Jesus. Look, Jesus loving, I'm forgiven. A woman, they brought a woman to Jesus.
That's a monologue, bro.
No. He's angry.
No, I'm going to ask my question after this.
No. So a woman came to him,
yes.
And they brought a woman to him, says stone her to death. Why? Because that is the Torah. The law of the Torah to stone the adulterous woman.
Correct.
Jesus said that the one who never sinned, let him through the first stone.
Yes.
So no one sinned, not everyone sinner, but according to even Moses and his time, they were sinners, but they still implement the law. Yeah. So my point here is, Jesus clearly, according to the Bible, that passage, did not establish the law of the Torah. According to the Jews, that's why they reject him. So now what do you say about it?
Answer, please.
Don't go away from that.
I like that.
If you don't answer that, I will be disappointed in you.
He does not know anything about the Bible.
He's a baby in the Bible. If you don't answer this, I'll be disappointed. He's a baby.
I want to come back to
it.
I've told you, Deuteronomy 18:15. If this guy is talking about the scripture, he doesn't have a key about the scripture.
He's giving me a Jew's opinion, so I don't have to respond to a Jew's opinion. I have to go by Deuteronomy 18:18, which is correct.
Excuse me. He has led. Let us admit whatever is the truth.
My brother.
He has stated that the Torah was to be fulfilled. Yeah. There's nothing. That's correct.
Yeah.
Let's not deny the truth.
Yeah.
Bring
although
the Torah.
Although somebody who is inexperienced in the truth is speaking, But let's not deny the truth when he mentions it.
Yeah.
Let us be honest.
Yeah.
Okay. Now,
the reason why I asked you this question, because I wanted him to let everyone know, because he's spoken, he always asks people about what is the criteria of a prophet.
Mm.
And he's given you some of the, like some of the visitors, he'll say, you know, some Jews say you have to stop the moon, the sun, or whatever.
Yeah, yeah, but remember that one. Did you watch it?
No, I've seen you.
That's the truth, the truth.
I haven't seen
it. No, you said, you asked
now,
you ask a question.
Now, yeah, I'm going to ask a question, but look, so I'm just giving, because he made several statements of what a criteria is. We go by Deuteronomy 18:18, or Paul, he says anyone who preaches another gospel.
No. Him be a, no, the truth is
let me finish. Now,
I look at Paul.
Let him,
I'm
me.
Saying
let
we as
Abraham. Are you?
Yeah, okay. Yeah. So now this is the interesting thing.
Okay.
Because if we go into the hadiths, right?
Look, hadiths. Bro,
no, listen,
thank you
very
much. Thank
wait,
you.
Wait.
He said the hadith. Okay. I like that one. No, wait.
No, wait.
Deal with my point. If you got off the topic, I'm walking off.
I'm not.
Deal with my point.
And I will say two things.
No, uncle. Wait. No, uncle. Let me make my point. Now, in the hadith, it says,
Jesus prophet. No, don't change the subject. Jesus opposed the Torah. He cannot be a prophet. You see, except as a prophet, deal with this point.
Okay, so in the hadith in Bukhari, it says, Abdul bin Salam heard the news of the arrival of Allah's
Abdullah
messenger whilst he was on the farm collecting its fruits. So he came to the prophet and said, I will ask you about three things which nobody knows unless he be a prophet. The first thing we have to understand is, how would this person know these questions if he's not a prophet? He said, I will ask you three things which nobody knows unless he be a prophet.
Wait.
Now let me finish my point.
Is that my point?
It says, firstly, he said, firstly, which is the first portent of the hour? What is the first meal of the people of paradise?
Yeah.
And what makes the baby look like its father or mother?
Yeah.
The prophet said, just now, Gabriel has informed me that about that. Abdullah said, Gabriel. The prophet said, yes. Abdullah said, he amongst the angels is the enemy of the Jews. On that, the prophet recited this holy verse. Whoever is an enemy to Gabriel, let him die in his fury, for he has brought it, the Quran down to your heart by Allah's permission. Firstly, we have to understand which Jews believe that Jibril is an enemy. He will have to provide us. Let me finish my point. My point is this. This person came to Muhammad to give him a trick question, which he answered with proof that he's a false prophet. This is why I'm going to prove from his own hadith that Muhammad is a false prophet. The first point. The man said that Jews hate angels.
What does the Torah say?
You should debate with him. Even if you're friend,
you
see, he's honest.
This is the thing. He's run off. Because the first thing is that the first point is this.
I will speak about it.
I'm going to speak to the camera. Because the first point is this. We have a hadith where someone in the Bible, you see, many of the Jews came to Jesus to trick him with questions. They ask him a question, for example, if a brother has a wife and he dies, and then the wife should go to the next brother, and if the older brothers die, when they go to heaven, who will be the wife of the heaven of the husband of their wife? So Jesus answered them, in heaven there is no marriage, because they kept asking him trick questions. That's why I asked him, what was the criteria of prophethood? So I wanted everyone to hear all the things that he said. So when we go to what this person said, we can establish that this is not a criteria established by any Jew. But that's why I got interrupted, because the first thing is, there is no Jew, for example, that believes that Jibril is an enemy of the Jews. They all revere Jibril. But Muhammad confirmed that Jews believe that Jibreel's an enemy. So then we have to say which Jews, because this is what, you know, I let him establish a criteria, and I wanted to refute this criteria.
Can I just sit this? The criteria for prophethood, yes, is in the Torah.
Yes, uncle.
And state that
uncle,
to them. Uncle, if you state what uncle, the criteria listen, in the Torah is,
uncle,
no Muslim uncle, can speak and listen, justify Muhammad
uncle,
through it.
They don't trust the criteria. We have to prove it from their criteria. Wait, uncle, you don't understand how sometimes people think. I understand what you're saying, and I know what your point you're making. We've had this discussion, but we have to prove from their own sources. This person, you show them from the Bible, they'll say it's they don't trust it. That's why.
So if they don't trust it means they're dishonest.
Uncle, what does the Bible say? It says you have to be wise
as a serpent.
Exactly. Now you've come in. Mm-hmm. I know what you're saying, but you have to let me do what I'm doing, because I know what I'm understanding. Because I know, yes, Deuteronomy 18:18. But this is the thing. In this hadith I was going to quote, he makes false prophecies. That's why we can refer it back to Deuteronomy 18:18. But I couldn't get to my point to prove it, because
did that is this. First and foremost, okay, please take this counsel.
Yes,
sir. Anywhere, anytime.
Yes, we always take counsel.
Please take this.
Yes.
And I don't think I'm smarter or wiser than you. You can't use a book full of truths and a multitude of falsehoods.
Yes.
To prove that a false prophet and a false god is false, you know, we can't. Now, first and foremost,
uncle,
allow me to finish. Okay. There are two books,
yes,
that their own false book claim to be a criteria of the truth.
Yes.
There is the Torah.
Yes.
And there's the Injil.
Okay.
Those two books, yes, have criteria to prove whether a prophet is false or true.
Yes.
Now, they cannot deny that. All they can attempt to say, oh, it has been corrupted. Yes. Oh, it's not the truth. So if it has been corrupted, then, yeah, why did your book say we should be fasting?
That's enough. Yeah, but this is what they talk about every week. So that's why you have
I've been coming here every week, exactly, too. For you know how many years?
But uncle, when you tell them that, they
don't use the truth as a criteria. Don't use the lie as a criteria for the truth.
No. Because in the Bible, it says you have to expose the lies. So in the hadith,
how do you expose the lie?
Because you go to their books and you show them a lie. And because, like you said,
the reason they believe a lie is because they've been reading their books,
exactly,
which is a lie.
So you have to then show the lies in their book.
So you use their book that is a lie to show them a lie.
No,
it
uncle.
It doesn't work.
Because it's
double.
No, uncle. Like you say, you show them and they don't believe it. So what's the point of me repeating the same thing as you have done?
Because that's the gospel.
Yes.
Listen to this. We are Christians.
Yes.
And don't forget it.
Okay.
For the gospel is the power of God unto salvation.
Yes.
I know many Muslims,
yes,
who are Christians today,
yes,
who heard the gospel of, yes, the truth.
If
you think you can convert somebody by your strength,
uncle,
the Holy Spirit weaponizes, yes, the word of God and changes these people. They are hearing it day in, day out.
When we go to Deuteronomy, even though we know the Quran, for example, is a false book, but then it says someone who speaks something like in my name that I did not speak, this is a false prophet.
Mm.
So then we can show them evidence from their own scriptures that confirms to this.
Now let me ask you a question. Yes. Using the book of Deuteronomy 18,
yes,
18 and 18:15,
yes,
how would you have answered the issue about Jesus Christ? Not, intentionally, he didn't say to them, "Thou shalt not stone this woman." He knew that, yes, by the Mosaic law, this woman should be stoned to death.
Yes, but uncle,
he brought back to them, but look, you want to condemn somebody and you yourself go as steeped in sin as she is. But notice there's a scripture in the same Mosaic law that gives permission to the prophet like unto Moses to say a word that is even superior to any Mosaic diktat. That's it, simple. Jesus Christ came to fulfill the law, but he also came to give a law beyond that.
Yes.
And the Old Testament that has the law provides for
uncle,
doing that.
But you have to give that message to people that want to understand. You understand?
People that want to understand.
Yes.
Do you know the people who want to understand in our message?
But this is the thing.
Answer that question.
No, but this is the thing. This is why also you have to show them from their own books. Because they revered this book so much. So when they hear that their prophet has made a false prophecy, because what I wanted to show is that there's a prophecy that no one can make an excuse for. Mm. So if they cannot excuse it, it's very clear. I can keep reading from ancient Deuteronomy, but it doesn't mean it. But I have to give them a concrete evidence from their source.
But you know, the point is this though. Yes. I can understand you wanting to expose the falsehood in their books.
Yes.
Jay does it. Many of us do it.
Yes.
I too, myself do. But one thing that you do not do is set a criteria for the truth. The criteria for prophethood. Mm. And then go to their books to be further.
But this is the thing, I've discussed him Deuteronomy before. That's why you've just come in, and I was trying to establish something because I've had this conversation with him before.
And then whether you've discussed it with him 100 times,
but that
criteria is still the criteria.
Course,
it doesn't change, it won't change, it remains the same. It's the thing you pound on again.
And I thank you for your intervention, but sometimes people...
I should just back out.
You know, because... Because the thing is, sometimes
you see, he was bringing up a point. Don't run away from them. No matter how steeped in the intention of intrigue.
Yes.
And that was, I knew why the intrigue that was there. I mean, I'm not a baby here, although I've got a lot to learn.
Of course.
I knew the intrigue. I know him.
Yes.
I mean, I love him. He will give his life to Christ in Jesus' name. I knew the intrigue he was trying to get. There are some times when they are bringing intrigue. Never, ever. Keep away from the truth. Don't deny the truth. Don't deny, even when it seems as if it's contradictory. Do not run away from that truth. The scripture, like I said, the gospel is the power of God unto salvation. It will never change. That's what the Holy Spirit works on. He convicts them of sin, of righteousness, and of judgment based on the word of God. That's your name. Take a vote. My name is Martin.